Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial we'll make this block in AutoCAD. Basically it is practice exercise 8 of this playlist in AutoCAD series, and I will provide its file in the description link so you can download it from there and you can practice. So let's go to here AutoCAD, and I will select new, and I will select this one ACAD, select this one open, and now you can see that a new drawing is opened. So first of all, I will put off these grids, and here you can see that I am in 3D modeling workspace. So if you are in drafting annotation, so you have to convert from drafting annotation to 3D modeling. And also I'll go to this one unsaved view, and I will choose this one southeast isometric, because I will draw my geometry in isometric. And let's say I don't want this UCS icon here, so just right click and select this one show UCS icon in origin. Okay. Now I'll go to this drawing, and here you can see that my base is 50 by 75, and here I am using default AutoCAD units. So let's say this 50 by 75 and the extrusion or the upward direction is 12. So let's go to your AutoCAD, and let's say I can close this file. So let's go to here line command, and let's say this line is 50 units and this line is 75 units. Basically it is a rectangle, 75 by 50 with extrusion is 12. So let's go to your AutoCAD, and here you can see that lines are not straight. So put on this one ortho so that you can make straight lines. So this dimension is 50 units, and this dimension is 75 units. Similarly, it is 50 and this one is 75. Okay. Now you can see that this rectangle is ready, and now I can use the press pull command or extrude command to extrude this rectangle 12 units. So let's go to your press pull command. Make sure that you are inside this bounded area, otherwise this press pull command will not work. So let's drag this upward 12 units. Okay. And let's go to here this drawing again, and here you can see that we have a cutout of 25 by 12 after 25 units. And here I will change this from 2D wireframe to, let's say, shades of shades with edges. Let's go to your line command, and let's say first I will sketch a 25 units line, and then this one 12 units, then 25 again, and then 12. Okay, now I can use press pull command to remove this material. So let's go to your press pull command, and you have to choose this area. Okay, this area, and I will click here. Now you can see that this material is removed. I will select this rectangle, and I will drag this to here, and now I can delete these lines. Okay, now you can see that we have a rib here, and this dimension is let's say it is 75. So 75 minus 20, 55 by 25. Okay, 55 by 25, and extrusion is 25. First we will create a rectangle, and then we will remove this portion. So let's go to your AutoCAD, and I will make this part separate, and then we will use move command to place this rib onto this rectangle. So let's go to your line command, and let's say this dimension is 25. This dimension is 55, this dimension is 25, and this dimension is 55. Okay. Now I'll go to here press pull, and I will choose this rectangle, and I have to choose this inside area, otherwise this press pull command will not work. And I will drag this to here, and I will write 25 units and press enter. Now I have to trim this part. You can see that we have 20 here, and we have let's say 55 minus 20, 35 here. Okay, and let's go to here line command, and I will draw one line here, 20 units, and then I will draw one line here, and then I will draw one line here. Okay, now we can use chamfer command as well to create this rib. Now I will go to here press pull command again, and now I will choose this area, okay, this rectangle. And I will drag up to, let's say, here. And now you can see that a rib is created. And now we will place this part, or we'll move this part onto this rectangle. So for this, I will change this to this one, 2D wireframe, so that I can view this vertex. So I will select this rib. I will select this command, move. I will select this vertex as a base point, and I will select this point. Okay. And now you can see that we have placed this rib onto this rectangle. I will delete this one. And also I can change this from 2D wireframe to this one. So here, as you can see that we have two solid bodies. One is the rib and other is the base. And now I will combine these two solid bodies into one single solid body. So for this, we have a command called solid union. And I will select this command, solid union. And first of all, I will select this rib, and then I will select this base, and I will press enter. Now these two solid objects are combined to create one object. I will select this object, and when I move this object, so basically these two objects will move together. So I will select this one, and now you can see that these two objects are combined. I will delete these lines. So that's how you create these 3D objects in AutoCAD. And if you have any question, any query related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.